Adebayo Bamitale, you're based, where are you based right now?
Yes,
I'm from
London.
Yes, we can.
Okay, so, good day to you, colleagues. I can't be special privilege to be today on actions. I think the father and competitor is holding is something indicative of the direction of the continent, and for that it makes me carry my heart, especially because I love Africa. I believe that the continent is in good position to be able to stand its ground in the community of continent. I'm going to my presentation now. First of all, I'm Adebayo Bamitale, I'm a Nigerian. I got a PhD from the African Center for Computer Science in Nigeria. And currently I work as a software engineer at UNGA in London. My research interest currently is on intrusion detection, cyber security, and how children can help them. I'm on a program at the Notre Dame University, London Campus. So, just for reduced strength and mind, so who will be responsible for it? Not my employees. Okay, so let's go to the outline of the presentation. I'll be talking about the role of what's happening in Africa today, the challenges that we face, and how packing and non-packing knowledge are tools for solving these, the issues with human experts, and why AI holds some promises, and also the promise of AI for mankind. Then we look at some steps that are necessary for the continent as a whole to really leverage the opportunities that are available from the AI domain. So we all know that Africa is having numerous challenges these days, and as it has always been, just like individuals, we all have challenges, and we work daily to face them in the same way it is with continent. But the thing that would worry us, would worry someone is the fact that Africa is not seeing, like, taking full advantages of the opportunities that are available to leapfrog and move forward. Gradually, that human work and companies like this are actually indicative of that direction. So, it should really be something of children that companies like this are taking in. A week ago, like I was saying, I was observing in North Africa, although this is not about that, and this is not about attack. When looking at the map, what I saw was actually that the dominant continent on the map was Africa. And that caused me to look at other maps, and I found that the map still stayed in the number of other maps. So the opportunities are there, the opportunities we need to do a bit more. Currently there are several challenges that the continent faces, and such challenges are attacking by professionals. Just like we know that when the journey from problem to solution is marked by knowledge, this has been demonstrated over centuries. When they require a magnitude of problem farming 7 years and 7 years and like that, which was reflected, the guy computer was, it was knowledge that helped to solve that problem. And that has always been the problem in this issue. In principle, whether packing or non-packing has been the key to solving problems, and that is the knowledge, the team, and the experience. we need such intelligence on according to India to solve the problem at the individual and corporate, national and continental level. So the opportunity that computing gives to us is the ability to actually participate in packaging skills, empathy, and knowledge in such a way that it will be deployed outside of human energy, which is the domain, which is the opportunity that this field gives to us, and which is one of the reasons why I think of it has been something that I value greatly. One of the problems is to solve any problem, we need human impact. But the problem with human impact is it takes time, it takes a lot of time to create human impact. There is not an estimate for the requirement of 10,000 hours to be able to produce a world-class expert in any domain, taking the name or God or whatever. He said that he needs approximately 10,000 hours of engagement to produce an expert in that area. And we can't wait for that approximately 10 years. It's impossible to wait for that 10 years in order to solve the problem that in something is done. I think we are country, like something is now, just now. So we need a way of tracking that length of time, and that is the opportunity that AI gives to the world. And that is the opportunity that AI is also holding for the African continent. Therefore, packaging effort make key experience and knowledge available. And that is the thing that in driverless vehicles, within that in drones, within it in intelligence, expert systems. But more than ever, things are beginning to also happen because of the convergence of internet, super computing, high computing power, the ability to embed intelligence. All of these things are beginning to actually transform things in the high terrain more effectively, to the extent that the cognitive time when you instruct your principal neurological to order food and vegetable and drink when the stuff is below the threshold and you don't have to pay anything. So we begin to have like assistance, we begin to have tools that are more intelligent than they used to be. There are certain issues related to this, but of course there are a lot of opportunities that have come. For me, after graduating, my thesis was on human and human issues, the relationship between human and past and present too. I was trying to look at especially experts and expert developers and their relationship to intelligent package tools. How do they relate to it? And there was some interesting points about it. So we needed to take into consideration the thoughts and feelings and experience of experts when we look at developing tools, because this is very important. In their issues that developers of intelligent systems need to understand so that they can package tools in a way that are usable, in a way that will be of benefit to the applicant user. Similarly, non-experts also are tracking, of course. They are, I was talking to CBS again when the driverless bus was introduced in Germany, and one of the things the news that happened was that it says the days of the bus drivers are normal. And this thing creates fear, and when you have fear like this, it makes it difficult for people to want to really like full attention invest in a certain system. I don't believe that such things are granted anyway, because in the driverless bus that we had in Germany yesterday, as an example, there was still someone sitting there to potentially to take control if anything happens. So I don't see any way we can actually reduce human beings totally. What I'm seeing, so I'm going to see, increasingly there will be need for artificial intelligence developers and experts. So, looking at the role that intelligence plays, the problem implement all sorts of improvements require keep empathy and integrity to deal with it. And in my experience in diverse areas, when I was talking about specialized and we're talking about generalized tools, all of these things hold important opportunities for making available the skills required to deal with the problem. For instance, the HEPAS system we deployed in medical domain and several other domains in the rural areas where they can also to get to diagnosis and other things. And some of these things will also be distributed to factual data and centralize it because of the availability of mobile systems. AI tools and techniques can also get detection and monitoring and responding to medical data and medical issues and hospital instructions. Methods will also help us understand more about things that cause and spread and deal with them effectively. We will also use models and ideas and tools to look at how to eliminate poverty and actually to ineffective distribution of resources, which is part of the key issues that confront the continent. Yes, not just for Africa. Offers a lot of opportunity for mankind itself. And that opportunity is that promise is in the definition of war. When we get problems and certain systems to deal with the choices of producing food, clothing, and shelter and other things to meet the basic needs of mankind, the question we have as mankind, what would we be doing? And I speculate that would lead mankind to be able to really the war. Spiritually, we'll be able to start doing things that today are in focus of breaking, and then, of course, the glory of mankind will manifest. And I believe that in that area, Africa can actually be a creator because of certain inherent capacity in the continent. These are big, certain and great high level. Human endowment. So, but to take that step, there are a lot of things that we need to take. The first thing we need to do, I'm asking that to be done every time that any one of us has a public support, is to reduce the fear that there are different human development. There are things that factors that contain affecting our future human. Human evolution and human development. I think we need to combat that everywhere we find it. AI will offer opportunities for job enrichment and for good and for spiritual development because then mankind will be free to be able to do what we need to move towards divinity. The issue is that man has the ability to move either towards divinity or towards animality. And when AI appropriately, we will stop being the beast of burden. We will then be effective and we have to have the global community. So, therefore, we need to pursue the continent, Africa's continent, through effective strategy in strategic solution in policy. In policy, in education, economic and cultural integration. We have to provide a position in the continent, the African continent. And also the government needs to know that AI is a strategic issue. Japan has been involved in a strategic and Japan really is doing a lot of developmental effort for that investment. And of course, the United States and a couple of these other continents that have been involved and actually invested here in what the benefits of doing this. But apart from actually just, we also have certain things that are inherent, certain things that are inherent in Africa, so that the humanitarian purpose in the human tradition. Such things we should take attention about it and try to find a group of packaging such knowledge and skills so that it become available for potential. In addition to that, companies should begin to look at embedding intelligence in business and services such that it would improve quality, and efficiency. So, our universities also have a lot to do. They need to begin to develop courses because they need to begin to develop courses that will be that will enable us to fill the skill gap that will definitely come out from the development of and use of artificial intelligence more prominently. And of course, there is a focus on humanity. A static core element that are particular to only human beings. Later, human beings are and machines cannot be dealt with details. The focus of mankind is to drive us and have. Of course, I believe that it's because we are here at this African, we should begin to feel good attention to such areas. I'm looking at creativity, I'm looking at autonomy, I'm looking at expensive manual facility, I'm looking at expensive perception, I'm looking at other areas, areas that we should begin to really look at these are as we delve more and more into AI and change the system. So I conclude, I say that AI offers the opportunity for every African forward, but we need to recognize the opportunity and to push the continent to take it. I thank you very much for listening and taking questions.
Thanks, Bayo. Appreciate that. Any questions for Bayo? Pretty difficult, Bayo. Thank you very much. Thank you. We really appreciate your time and being on standby. Thanks, Ben.